Hey, what's up, guys? It's our DGG player back in the game for a bit. Today I'm going to be playing Strixhaven Sealed. So, yeah. I haven't posted in a while of arena content, so it's and since Strixhaven just came at the perfect time. I've looked into the set a bit, and it looks pretty cool. Yeah, and like, I'm right now at a point where, like, since I have so many other interests, Magic's just kind of been fading out for me. But I still love the game Deer, for sure. Yeah, but it's just like, especially with the situation going on now, it's not a lot of time to go to my LGS or anything. I used to always go play sealed, but like pre-release sealed, but now, yeah. And I feel like I'm just in a point where I don't really want to buy in-person cards, kind of just chill in arena, it'd be fine. Yep, let's get right into this. So let's open up, see what we have. Ooh, Sign and Blood, okay. Interesting. This is I forgot what it's called. It's like archive cards, I think. I forgot what they're called. But the Beldro's Witherbloom. So maybe we can go and play like a Golgari, or in this case, Witherbloom. It's pretty good. I think each upkeep you make a pest on each upkeep, so on your opponent's. And when they die, you gain a life and you can pay 10 and you can untap all your lands, which is insane. Strixhaven Stadium's really cool. It's an alternate win condition. You tap, you put a point counter on it. So it's just a 3 mana rock, and you taps for, and you get a point counter on it. If a creature would deal common damage to you, it removes a point counter. Or if you deal common damage to the player, you get point counters. And if it's 10 or more, they lose the game. And which in 1v1 means you win the game. A Draconic Intervention. Sticks to see. X damage to each non-dragon creature, where X is the number of XO cards made about. Creature does damage this way with the XL set, so good board wipe. Silver Coast Silencer. It's about just non-limit card. Whenever a point cast a spell with the name, they lose 3 life and you draw a card. That's interesting. And then Wandering Aryek. I can't. But whenever a point casts into sorcery, they may pay 2. If they don't, you may copy that spell and choose the target to the copy. So basically taxing them, or else you get it. Or you have Explorer, the Vastlands, which is 3 mana. Each player looks at the top 5 cards of their library and may reveal a land card or an instant sorcery card from them. Each player puts the cards they revealed this way into their hand and the rest in the bottom right in order. Okay. I mean, it looks like they're designed meant like this one, lets you search for cards. Everyone search for cards and put, and then you play the Wandering, the avatar, the front card, the creature. And then if they get instant sorceries from the cards they got, then you can just copy them, unless they pay 2. Alright. Oh, we got some more of the archive things. Divine Gamut, like, so, artifact creature, enchantment, punk controls, so put a permanent card from hand to buff it. Memory Lapse. I do like Memory Lapse. Good card. Good counterspell. Infuriate, +3/+2, not bad. Snakeskin Veil, like that. Harmonize? It can be really good. I think we'll try to build a green-black deck, so let's see what we can do here. You can also play Square Up, since it's basically like a mono-green card, pretty much. It's fine, discount it, so play a draw card and discard a card. I mean, honestly, this card might be not that bad. Worst case, I'll just play the 3 and then we all get value, but I kind of want to do tricks. So yeah, I've experienced science as a lesson, so I want to keep these in my sideboard if I do have any learned cards. If not, I don't feel like they're worth really a run, though, to have. It's basically like the Gateway Plaza, I think it was a Riptide Rupture. Ooh, Pest Summoning, it's a good lesson. Pestilent Cauldron. Oh, it's in a rare. Why wasn't it shown? I think it showed like some archive cards instead, that's why. Discard a card, create a 1/1 black and green pest. Creature token, when this creature dies, you gain 1 life. Pay 1, each opponent mills cards equal to the number of life you gain. Except 4 cards from a single graveyard, draw a card. Or sorry, the burst. Two of the 2 creatures and play draw cards from your graveyard to your hand. Each player gains 4 life and exile it. That's pretty good. trying to organize here. Okay, all right. Blood Researcher and gain life counters. Yeah, the whole theme of Water Bloom is just life gain. Okay, X, 1-1, like, pest. Yeah, where X is sacrifice creature's power, okay. Fuse with Vitality. Until the turn, target creature gets Death Touch. When this creature dies, returns a weapon. Turns out to control the... Oh, that's a good combat trick. Ooh, Dina, Soul Steeper. When you gain life, each opponent loses one life. Sacrifice it. Our creature gets plus X plus zero. So if you give it life, then it's... Oh, Witterbloom Campus. Put that in. Then we got Four Weeder, 7-6. If we give your upkeep, sacrifice creature. We sacrifice... each of it discards card. Oh, so, like, you can, like... Maybe, like... what I would do is just, like, sacrifice the first one and then attack with it and then just let it die. Or maybe it can just be used as a blocker and then... And then you just do the thing. Oh, Mortality Spirit. That card's so good. Such a good... The store non-land permanent, first of all. And then I'm playing Witherbloom, so I'm definitely going to be gaining life and then just destroy something. For only black, green. That's just a better Putrefy. It's just so much better. Yeah, we'll definitely put that in too. Just want to keep out gun because of Lesson. There's another. When you cast it, copy or instant. Or it's a Magecraft, so put counter on it. Maybe. I think we do have a lot. Some instant sorceries. Yeah, we do. Yeah, just forget. We do have the cards that have, like, the thing in there. What am I saying? The hybrid mana symbol. If I blanked on that name. Okay. In fact, X, what's the number of lands you control? I mean, not being seem to ramping much, but we'll see. Harmonize is good. Good defensive creature, I guess. Let's guess the number of sources your creature gets plus one plus two in fight. Tame into a breach, it's a lesson, so probably the one. And it also destroys our fake enchantment, so you have to have to be a side worker. Big play, creature gets plus two plus two in reach and put a plus one counter on it. Snakes and Bailed for sure. Gain 2 life, target creature gets plus X plus X plus X and then life you gain. That's a good card. If you don't have any ways to learn, I'll put some of these cards in. Search our creature, Planeswalker. When the creature blocks his turn, his controller loses 1 life. Oh, that can be like a really aggressive card. Each player loses 2 life, you draw 2 cards. It's not bad. You negging both of you for 2 and then drawing 2? Yeah, I'll keep. I have 2 of them. Why not? And then dice. Yeah, plus some counter draw card. Exact creature you can draw except friend. Yeah, hell yeah. Onyx Urge Twins. Yeah. So the whole, I've heard the whole story is like this, like, thing, this creature called Exodus or something like that. 2 of those. But draws 2 cards and loses 2 life. It's a double black, so like, life, it's a expensive ability. That's a 2-3 flyer, so it's not bad. So we definitely have stuff, but the problem is we don't have any way to learn. Learning is not something we're doing here. So I kind of want to feel like splashing our card would be good just so we can use some learn. If we have any. But there's so many cards, there's some of these cards I would consider main warning. I think blue learns a lot because of, like, I literally do not think I have, like, any learn. Yeah, I just don't have any way to learn. Pest summoning, is that good enough? I think the colorless ones are definitely not, but I think maybe pest summonings. Think about pest summonings. Termination Reach, well, that's an artifact chamber thing, so So I don't want to main more than that. I mean, we have our big dragon here. Alright, what do I want? I like all these are good. We could play. I might just take big play out because I already have some other good things here. Square up, yeah, I'll take that up. Mage duel. Take like some of these crocs out. I do love the Pestilent Cauldron, it's a good card. I think we just take that out. Got the stadium. Part of me kind of wants to, but crushing this, we can take out one crushing disappointment. I mean, I feel like a minimum we're gonna get six, well maybe five if we just use the Strixhaven Stadium, but still. Still, I guess it's good early. It's just we need a play to play. We need just something to play. We'll do that. Or late game, we just top deck and it's not dead at all. Cause even if we've been like drawing a few lands before, it's still great. I don't know about the Spectre, it's so much mana. Mage duel. I mean, our removal is already good. I don't think we need this because it's just we're not. That's not our main focus. Lands, we're running 17. We can cut one. Our highest end is only just a 7, 6. Everything else is 4 or less, so I think we're fine. I do want it. I still have to take something out. Let's take one of these out. Okay. I think this is good. This is fine. Other big dragon as her card. Yeah, let's start. Goodness. Alright, so this hand is, like, pretty okay. Yeah, I think we rock with it. We'll harmonize. Not our land, which is what I want. I'll just pass. I got greedy. And of course when I draw is a land that comes into play tapped, so you can even keep developing the board. Oh, I don't know. Yeah, I kinda don't like that. Well, now we have access to Harmonize, so we can definitely do that later. Black Pest, okay. I could kill that. Well, I think I want to play my big boy. And I can also just put a plus and counter on it, or give it indestructible. I'm just going to try to do something. Unless he like, tries like an exile effect, then I can't, but Yeah, this card's pretty good. I think he's just wearing green blacks. I think he actually only used it for the black part, which is smart, honestly. It's really good. Especially in the, like, in the green black deck, where sacrificing is, like, used a lot. I think it's really good. Does he have, like, a sacrifice thing? If he has this, then this is bad. Oh, just a trample, like. Well, I have to sacrifice it. But at least it held him off for a turn. Discard card, I draw a card. Chain two. Let's play this. I can't exile to do that, but let's hold off. But because I can pretty much block everything. Opponent controls more lands. You search of three planes. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, he just gets to draw more lands. Pretty good. This is a good 2 mana draw game. Yeah, I got because the lands are cards too. Oh wait, I can just. A good block there. Ooh, okay, so what I want can turn two things, but I have nothing right now, really. I'm taking the aggro. I'm playing the beat down now. Already had in life, so yeah, I think I just put the beat down. Reinforce pressure. He has another one? I love that. Man has a whole nother Embros. That's lucky. I didn't get two. I want to kill it. I need to just keep enforcing. I'm gonna enforce it. Ah, God's willing. It's annoying. And I just lost my creature, but that's fine. From the professor's willing. The only problem is I have to hold up. Yeah, but you can just turn that pest into a life card. You're just gonna put it on Embros if you're smart. I'm not the right play. Because if he attacks, I just have refreshing blade. And promising dusk mage. I'm gonna keep this professor's willing up. Because it can oh yeah, he's gonna keep buffing that up. It's gonna be annoying, because once it's at 5 I don't have much to deal with it. And that God's will. I can't stop that. Alright, well now he's on the beat down. I'm on the defensive. Okay, so we gotta think. Yeah, because basically he just turned this game around. He's now. It exiles. That's so bad for me because I have. I can give indestructible, but that doesn't protect against exiling. Yeah, it's a hard. Yeah, harmonize. Things. least the pests are good blockers. Because they just give you up a life. So they're annoying blockers. Well, now they don't because of that. I mean, at least I don't lose any life because if I block with pest, but... So, yeah. That card's so good. I don't want to lose my pump on this mage. It's fine, because I guess get something back in the past, so mage not worth too much. Eater, but he's probably just gonna just introduce the annihilation out. So. He had two. How do you freaking have two? What? He didn't have two. How? That's just the dumbest thing to me. he had two. Oh, good. Oh, wait, this is really good. I can play my Union though and use that as bait for the Infused Annihilation and then just put down the Beldros and start clapping. That's really good. Please introduce the Annihilationist. Please, I beg you to. I am begging you to introduce the Annihilationist. So then I can just freaking. No, he's just buffing. He's just making that beefy. Please introduce the Annihilationist. I'm begging you. Please. Do it. Come on. It's out to it. Oh my god. He has another way. That's so annoying. Are you kidding me? Of course. Well, like, I have to wait again because I don't want to put the King Belder outside to use that because he's immediately just going to introduce the Annihilation. In another way, XO. Expanding the Tommy. I don't care about that. I need like skin snake. If I can get that, that would be really good for me, because I can just play Beldros and then have the snake skin build up. So that would be a perfect top deck for me. So much learn. Oh my god, I wish I had all this learn. I had to main deck some of my lesson cards because I don't have any learn. Attacking. Only crit hit. I can afford six for now, I think. I think I just have to play Belder no matter what, because I can't play a hole. Because I'm already about to die, so I just can't. I literally just can't. Have to. It's gonna get introduced to Annihilation, but at least to get passed off it, get the removal spell out of the way. It's whatever. It's gonna happen. Me, it's gonna get introduced to Annihilation right now, but whatever. Mm-hmm. Yep. I still buy two skin snakes. More talent. It actually might be useful. Because the pest will give me a life. So. So destructible. this, I can't log this or whatever. What's more threat name? Emrose is pumping. I have to kill something. Yeah, I'll carry the guard. That was a guard weapon. I mean, I'm just gonna die. Well, with this, I might live a turn. Actually, I don't think I live a turn. I mean, he just had this freaking amazing that freaking two freaking rares in the same pull. It's insane already, but it's whatever.
That's too much lucky.
You got lucky. I mean, that's the thing about Magic, it's just a percentage of the game is just luck. The percentage of the game is literally just all luck. I guess it'll probably be a slower game. So I definitely don't want this turn yet until I harmonize, just because harmonize give me more cards to discard. But I guess I'll just play it now. Discard. Yeah, just discard that. I mean, my deck's pretty good, I just need to get going. If I can get a good, like, hand and opening, I can really get it. That's funny. This can't. Six for Jackie. That's pretty good. So I could use my professor's warning here, indestructible, then tend to pest. Yeah, that's right. I don't want to discard my card. Two good removal spells, a good setup card, protection, and draw cards. Forest, so I can just harmonize. So I can just get more cards of this thing. Of course, when I say I need a forest, that's what I get. It's fine. I can just hold them. I can use Mortality Spear, but I kind of don't want to. That is gonna be obviously bad. That is dead. Being that's living? No, that's not living at all. That's dead. It's immediately gone. Yeah, I am playing with that. Conway, you may choose two. Yeah, 2-1 2. I'll slow die. He really just beefing. Flying, so six flying damage in the air. So that's really gonna shake up the race. Attack? I was like, yeah, you probably should just attack with that. What? I didn't. Combat. Okay. That needs to die. I can't do anything else. I spend 4 mana doing that. So I'll just end step. One away from that, that's annoying. I just put the creatures out. Two, four, and four, two. 4-2's tapped, of course. I think it's 2 cards, so if he has removal for that's fine. I'm still not dead. I mean, it would hurt. I'd go to 4. It'd deal 4. I'd go to 3. Damn. Really? So you exiled my thing. Well, at least it's not my 2-4 blocker. Storm, expanding with enemy, okay. Just 2 counters and vigilant to turn through. Okay. Spend your mana, please spend your mana like that. So we can't deal with this. The only thing we have is just 20. That. Yeah, sadly I won't be able to get to that pay 10 life. anytime soon, really, but it's fine. I think I just... Did I play defense? Nah, I'm gonna go with it. I have 10 to pass for versus warning next game, but I think I'm fine. But now, and I'm just making a bunch of blockers. No way right now I see for him to get flying. That might literally just kill me. Now I'm not even have to just attack me to just do that. And they'll probably not attack or block the pest if I attack with the pest, because yeah, I just know I just get life. Six, seven. Turn the game around. Attack again. I mean, you can't get through my pass blockers. I just have infinite blockers at this point. So his plan should be literally just to try to kill me with the Witherbloom Apprentice. Make it 9-9. Now we're getting somewhere. Now we're at a point where we can really start pressuring him. Now we're doing something. And I still just have 10 to pest, so I can just, if he tries to kill my Bedrock or the 9-9, boom, I'll just make that many 1-1 pest. So I really can just do it all right now. I don't know how he's gonna get out of this if he doesn't, he keeps breaking. But this, the best way for him to win right now is just the Apprentice, for sure. It's only real agency for them. Yeah, since I have all these, I'm just gonna play that. And I have a bunch of tricks up my sleeve. Alright, just one block in, okay. I'm gonna turn it back probably. So he has an infinite blocker, I guess. And I can't really get rid of it because he doesn't have enough cards in his graveyard for me to do that. Because I already exiled a lot of them. So. It's fine. Eventually I'll just build up enough pest to where I can't really do much. That makes sense. I don't think... I had two cards I gave indestructible. One that gave hexproof, and one that just let me just cash out any of my big creatures and turn make them go wide. So yeah, I don't think it was pretty uphill battle for them. It's gonna be pretty rough. Oh, this is gonna get 3 drop. Thank you. So yeah, I just love Professor's Warning. That's cool. A one drop play, Nunny. What's this do? Because we die, so instead, when you do pay two, make create one more black green pest, okay. We'll go greater than. I kinda don't like that. That's okay, nice. You may pay one if you do put counter on creature, gets trampled on the turn. That's cool. Interesting. Main decking environmental sciences. Interesting. Well, I have that, but I wouldn't main deck it. I don't need to just tutor it out with. This is better. Maybe next turn I can give it a counter in case it dies. So just draw a card. I mean, I don't want it because I really like to keep Professor's Warning. I guess naming next time I'll probably just hold up, like, things so they have Mortality Spear, or the Professor's Willing. I'll probably just play Black Green Creature and hold the Professor's Willing, that's probably better. Double Strike. No, also Pest Summonings. I think it's better to play Researcher before. Okay. Not playing Screamy. I wouldn't like Scar my deck, it's pretty good. Just any removal spell I turn, I can just pay 2 extra for a 1-1 pass that gains me life, which will help me in turn. Set me up. 1-5. Big blocker. Big butt. Ooh, I don't snakes in there. I'd rather roll snakes in the wheel. Snakes in the wheel. The Professor's Warning. It literally does both. And better, because Hexproof is way better. Then Indestructible, because Hexproof. Because Indestructible can't get around exiles, Snakes can build can, because if you like it's just a solo target exile removal, then yeah, stop it. And it always gives the counter. Cultivate, okay. Nice. So I could try to aggress do the Mage Hunter's Onslaught on the 1-5. I mean, he would just sack in response and get like probably Cultivate back. I don't know if I want to do that. I mean, the only really attack with that can just double block and then I'd lose. Still keep his 1-2. I don't think it's smart enough yet to do that. Pests are really good with the Blood Research because I can just double block something like the 2-2 and then I just would get 2 counters on this, so it's basically yeah, just putting me, like the power on this would just be a 4-4 menace. Still waiting right now. Ooh, this might make an act because this step, I can tap it, not just for mana, but just to add a point. And if he wants to keep staying like this and not attacking me, I can just eventually just build up 10 points and win. I'll bite. What do you have for me? What are your con metrics? +2, +2. So that's pretty much 3 power on that. I guess I'll just... yeah, I'll just save it. That's really cool. Yeah, at least it's not like a, if that was trampled, that'd be more scary. But... so we will just use a lot of just get nothing. Should I get rid of Twin Skull Shaman? I think this isn't a sorcery. I'm making my shaman, so I'll just get rid of it. Damage on it, basically. So he's gonna do a thing XL or something, and I'm gonna for the XL. No, I'm afraid. Oh wait, no, that sacrifices it. I thought I was just tap and get it, but it sacrifices it. So it just chills. So that's 4-4 first strike. And you can't do anything else to it with the hexproof. I'll just block. And that'll also just block. First strike actually hurts him there. That's the first strike hurt him there. Because of the first strike, I gained the life before. So the mortality tree was able to activate. That's so funny. That's so funny. That first strike actually hurt him right there. First strike actually hurt him because I gained the life before the Tome Shredder could do damage. So I was able to mortality spear to save my promising Dust Mage. So first strike actually was worse for him there, because if it was just regular damage, my promising Dust Mage would have died. It's okay, it's just trying to aggro me. Okay. Cool. That's fine. He's gonna sacrifice it. I think he's gonna get back the mask on reception so he can just do that again. Maybe he's smart. 6-4 on my face. At least it goes back to me and stuff, so I didn't even get the upkeep triggers. So I had to remove a point from my stadium. I feel like, honestly, if he was doing the smart, he should have just sacked the Pillow Drone Warden and got this back. And just kept enforcing the pressure on me. He has a reach, so I can't really attack, which is sad. Otherwise, I would definitely be attacking with Wither Bloom. Well, I'll just eventually win. Because I have enough attackers. Even though I can't. Because I'll have enough attackers where I can just do damage to him. Where I can get it hidden. I really have enough attackers where I can just attack it, get it hidden, and then... Because you can't keep up with Wither Bloom's token generation. You just cannot. I think I forgot to tap it last time, but that's fine. I'll just tap it. Remember to tap it. Stop on the next step. Even if he kills Wither Bloom, the damage is going on. Or I can just give myself a clear target. It doesn't give me the life, which is unfortunate, but still picking a 1-1 out for that. Oh, but now he's gonna get back the mascot and reception. Oh, he didn't. That's interesting. He should have. That's what he should have done. He should have just paid two. Got back mascot intervention. Eh, what did I know? I don't know what he's planning. Oh, well, does he have the thing? That card? No, it's fine. Can't do much. I was just gonna turn around it. I thought you had the reach card. Okay. Can I win? Oh yeah, come on. So, but just in case. Safe. I'm gonna play it safe. Just so I guarantee get it hidden. Now this could be risky because I'm gonna put myself to 4. So. But I'm trying to go for the win. Oh wait, no, I thought that untaps all your permanents. I'm stupid. Wait, so whatever, one or more. Is it, does it say one or more? Oh no, I just went. I forgot. I thought it said one or more. Because that just gives me enough points. Well, I thought you were going to start. I should have started with it. Yeah, I win. Unless he has something right now. He actually won with the Strixhaven Stadium. Let's go. Oh, that's so funny winning with the alternate win condition, man. Alright, let's just keep going. Can't stop one stop. Let's see how it works. Yeah. This is crazy. We'll see how well we can do. Geiger. Oh, I wish I had that card. That's so good. Oh, I love that card from my deck. I mean, it's an uncommon. I mean, it's understandable. It's a one of flyer that dies learn. I'll get poked for one damage. The researcher. Till next turn, since I don't have double green for harmonies, I'll just play the Spectre Defense. I'm gonna fine. Be my guest. Do it. Kill it out. Kill it. Okay. Huh. Hey, okay. Pretty good. Doubles as a maneuver plus pump spell. Your defense. Don't tell me you're just gonna. Don't tell me you're a black white control deck, are you? Don't tell me that now. And also, yeah, if you like full Esper control, is the worst. Oh, but I love playing them though. I'm super hypocritical, guy. Things I love playing, I hate going up against. Like control, I love playing control. I hate going up against it. Just control, just when you play, it feels so fun. It's just like, ha, you can't do that. Oh, you thought you were gonna do this? No, you ain't doing that. I'll attack. I'll let you learn. If you want to learn, I'll let you learn. Okay, you can learn. It's gonna plus two it. Well, I'm gonna do this. So he learns. So I'll just come back to that. So same outcome. Check this out, creature put a counter on it. +1/+1 and learn, okay. Keep learning. Doing summoning. Ward, pay 3 life, that's annoying. 3 flyer too. But I'm gonna do it. Trying to, of course, beat them on me. Blackish Trunge. Alright, Trunge, whatever. Revitalize, okay. So yeah, I'm just gonna sack this Tentacle Pest. Sad I didn't manage to bring it back, but fine. Harmonize. Reflex. Oh, this is perfect. Second hold of Professor's Warning plus or just bring back the Trudge. As soon as I heard the word inkling, I just immediately, of course, that was for Toonie, because that's just me. Do I bite? That's a question. Oh. We got some. Oh, good. I took that. Why didn't Inklings have flying though? Ooh, hi. Hey, look. I just use my things. I don't want to. That back. No, not the back. 5-6 in the air. You get a jump block with your Inkling. No, it's taken. Okay. Respect. I respect it. Oh. That's a problem. That's a big problem. I don't like it. So you have like the sack thing too? Oh no. But I don't have enough mana to keep Witherborn. Blackish Trunge. can't heal me. If you wanna play beat them, I'll play beat them. I'll definitely play beat them. Block. Anything? Any tricks? So that's gonna make it a 4-3. Press point is gonna be perfect. It's gonna be a 3-5, so it's literally gonna just be perfect to take it out. Because I won't have enough power to kill, and I also have enough, and one, it doesn't have enough pup. So we're chilling. He has to hold up if he wants to live right now. He cannot attack. If you want to live, don't attack. Unless he's greedy. Since he's out of cards, I guess it's time. Pass. I have enough to win with 6 and Saber. He can block one thing. 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't think I have enough. I can tap it for one. I was just looking to see. That is fun. I don't know if he did. We're at 12,000 gems. How many do we need to pay it back? We have to get to 6 wins if we want to like get our money back. Our gems back. But so it's still pretty good. Let's play some drafts, which will be great. I'll definitely be doing some drafts also. Yeah, when a new set... I think I'm just gonna... Every time a new set comes out, I'll... upload some content and probably just start drifting away and then you stick to that content. I think this is how it's gonna go. I wanted to try it every week, but I just don't really like it sometimes. Like, arena is. Don't get boring. Okay, this is a nice one. Cause it's just the same pool over and over. The same cards. But with new set, we have more fresh, so it's definitely way better. A lot more fresh. I mean, what they can do is just get flying to evade, but... Or just remove it, but okay. Take that, just a vanilla 2-4, I don't care. I'd rather you take that up in my blood researcher. Remorse. Just gonna get rebelled or something. I don't need Belderos really. He's more of a finisher card anyway, so. He just helps. Speed the game up. And it's always good, like, when they do their reveals, and they like, draw cards just so we have more cards so we don't know what it is. So, like, okay. I don't like him being life, so... Name's gonna chill. We're trying to experience the professor's warning, so we're chilling. And also, it's not gonna let him get life because, yeah, he has to pick flying. I'm biting. Fucking lightning bolt, are you kidding me? In that lightning bolt. Card exile to our creature. Planeswalker. I mean, okay. Mama doesn't have a card. That's fine. And I get a draw card, so. Okay, I take it. The thing is, if I'm Mortality Spear, I have nothing else to do. Now we got productive. So, yeah. I want to bike. This thing is Mortality Spear. It costs so much, I have no life gaining, so it's not gonna. It's annoying. It's 4-1. Vigilance. You can dunk run of it. I'm just gonna have to fucking deal with everything in combat, Professor. It's the only way if he makes more plays before then. That's not gonna be that good. I mean, I have to attack. Anything else we really to do? I mean, I think they just have it. It's this, but... mean, I would have liked to use with my Brackish Trun. 4 pass. That's what it is. Okay, and now I have to pull up. And I have infused with Vitality, so or I can just sacrifice the pest for a life, so. Scry one out of this. Definitely not what I need. Perfect. So I can live one more turn, depending on what the card he has is. My ammo's half. Use a vitality. That'll let me live for longer. Okay. Keep the front joke. Heck that. If you want to lose some things, then that's fine. I know you have no combat tricks. Just gonna block there. Okay, I'll just have to pass. I mean, right now I definitely would love my freaking dragon, but it's whatever. I mean, also, I think if I buy my dragon, I think I'd be probably in a winning position because I can easily just get over that inkling. Alright, nice play. Introduction to Annihilation. Good get. So, even if that's dice enough for me, let's take out anything. Maybe better for planning ahead, so you might block and stuff. Oh, yes. That's a good job. top. Because now, I can get rid of that freaking inkling, so I'm not in danger all the time of freaking dying. It's gonna use that. Makes sense. I get a draw card though. I have my. Only took Well, I'll just find that thing. Alright, would have been campus. Take that out. And pass because yes, still keep up defense. I don't like that. Nobody would assume. I get one life, but is that, well no, it's not enough, am I just dead? Blockers, I'm stupid. I should have just put just the pest on. That's what I should have just done. I should have just put the pest in front of the thing. That was stupid on me. I should have just put the pest in front. Alright, it's fine. I mean, I don't think I was literally in such a rush, but I don't think I would have gone out. I think if I still, if he just didn't early game just take away my dragon, I would have won. I think I actually probably would have won that. It's whatever. I'm not gonna be greedy on that. Oh yeah, it's fine. Only would sacrifice a wall. Learn. That would have been cooler. Teamer deck. Opt. I mean, so that puts me. just 10 to pet sacrifice it, or I'll just whatever you can't describe. That's definitely impactful when I can use it. But it's not like a bad effect, but I'm still winning a race because we're both just doing three. The only thing is that overrun actually is just giving them life every turn, which is annoying. And I just played more creatures, so. This was definitely around stuff, just I always remember the scry. Because I need to find a land. For the campus. So I'm saying put two counters on that. I would rather. Should I just tend the pest? Ugh. Or should I just replay the blood researcher? I think that 10 to pass is a lot better. It also gives me fodder for the necrotic fumes, so I can finally use that. You know, then my instep stop because that's prime. I could play this, but I think it's better to just, you know, this. Get rid of the 4-4. Perfect. And hopefully if the next turn I draw a land, I can play Blood Rose plus hold up a Snakeskin Veil. Because I'm pretty sure he would have countered if he had a counter spell. I don't know exactly the counter spell for this set. I was just gonna sack it and learn. What are you getting? Don't get freaking the 5 mana colorless one. Please. Please. I mean, I still have Snakes and Dillas, so it's fine. Oh, no, Fractal Summoning. Okay. Make a big fractal, okay. Well, right now we can make a 5/5 fractal. Or if that's a land, you can make a 6/6 fractal. Or if you draw something, you can make a 6/6 fractal. Start one. play Fractal Summoning. Come on. I have no creatures now. So it's in your best interest to go into beatdown. So you should play your Fractal Summoning. Or maybe he's right now just paying X for it. Please. Just play Fractal Summoning. Please.
Please?
Yay. Yes, I am. That is the creation I want. Come out, Melrose. This card's like so good, man. What do you got? What do you have? Can it be the snakeskin mail? We'll see. Unless you have two things at instant speed. Maybe it's like a fight card. I know some master symmetrists. Pretty good. It's annoying. That gets trample. Fuck you. I have the biggest fractal in town. And you're supposed to be Prismari, and I have the biggest fractal. Ha. Screw you. I have a bigger fractal than you. How about no? Her point? No, not really. Let's see, I keep drawing. I guess I can keep drawing booty. Now I can attack. It's a 4/4. Unless they want to use Christmas. I'm pretty sure they don't. But honestly, yeah, they're gonna win. It's just a master symmetrist. So if he attacks with Master Symmetrist, I'll just put 4 block on that. If he has nothing, I'll just eat it. I'll gain 4, so. But I don't know if I want to be greedy on it. Should I be greedy? I think it's the only way I can actually just try to win, so I'm going to greed it. Okay. That's fine. Then. What? Oh my. I don't get the triggers first? Come on. Dang. It's only whatever, it's fine. Good, because I kind of wanted to end and even have drafted that, but not crap. No, it's fun, yeah. It's kind of a long video, it's 1:30. Retriever Phoenix. Ardina. Hurts Fae, oh dang. Boom Command. Choice. Alright, well, that was it. Hope y'all enjoyed. I'm definitely gonna be sure to open more arena content, do drafts, some maybe deck techs on some of the legendary creatures, and all that. So, hope you guys enjoy, and our DMG player, out.